So I was recently opening up LinkedIn and I saw this post by Kalpit Virwal wherein he was talking about how he won't be sitting for placements in IIT Bombay. Now that's a big deal to be honest with you, right? If you take a look at basically IIT Bombay is the best college in India that you can find for engineering and he's not sitting for placements. That made me realize that this is an actual field that is coming up lately. You know, we see Aman Dhatarwal, we've seen Kalpit Virwal, we've seen Sejal, and we are seeing a lot of people who are in college. They don't sit for placements and they directly take up some business with the help of YouTube. So I want to talk about this concept and I think this is really interesting. So I thought, let me just talk about this for a moment. Okay, let's get started with this video. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Ishan Sharma. And before we start talking about any of the things inside of this whole discussion, I want to talk about this interesting quote that I recently read. This was from Naval Ravikant, and he was talking about how you would never become rich by renting out your own time, which essentially means you won't ever become wealthy by doing freelancing or by doing a job. You would only become rich by having a stake or some equity in a company. In 2019, I saw Aman Dhatarwal in one of his videos where he was telling that he won't be sitting for placements. And that was crazy for me to think about because, again, I was preparing for JEE. And after JEE, what you do, you get into a college and you study for placements. And then came Kalpit Virwal. He started making these videos, started AcadBoost as a blog. I remember back in those days, he was giving some advice for JEE aspirants as well as people who want to learn coding and all. And then slowly, he made it into this huge place where people can learn and prepare for IIT as well as other skills. And recently, he even made a video in which he's talking about how he wants to develop India and he wants to stay in India and not work for some other company overseas. So this is really interesting. But basically, what you need to understand about placements is that whenever you get a job, what you're working, you're not getting paid enough for that. Because there's something really interesting about placements. What happens is that if you get placed at some company, like some IT company, there was a research study done recently in which it was calculated that in US, every single Google employee makes almost $1.6 million profit for the company Google itself, and they get paid about $200,000. So you're not getting paid as much as what value you are providing for the company, okay? But still, $200,000 or in India, you know, 40 lakh rupees package, that's really an amazing deal because we have never really worked in our life before that. We have never really had a job. We've never really started a business before, going for placements. But then you realize that you will be working every single day for 9 hours or how many hours you work at your company. And all of the bigger rewards will be taken up by the people who have stake, who have equity in the company. So that's where the big problem is, okay? A lot of you are just running after placements and you don't understand the bigger picture. Then there are these people who take a different route, okay? People like Aman Dhatarwal, people like Kalpit Virwal, and they start off with YouTube. Now, YouTube for college students is really interesting because in college you have a lot of free time, right? You can do a lot of stuff in college and you can still make up for it at the end by preparing for placements if nothing works out. You won't get a lot of monetary value when you are just starting out in YouTube because again it is very much competitive and AdSense is just not enough. Okay, if you take a look at how much money I made in the first 6 months, it was completely zero. Okay, but I was still making videos every single day and I was struggling really hard. Okay, so that is where I think college plays a very important role. You can work really hard on your YouTube channel when you are in college, and still, if nothing works out, you can just start preparing for placements, and that can be it for you. Or if this YouTube channel blows up, if one of your videos or several of your videos end up, getting viral, or you get up a lot of subscribers, a lot of attention, a lot of engagement, you can skip placements. And why does that happen? If you take a look at what are the streams of income that a normal YouTuber has who is in college, number one is AdSense. That is the most normal one. Then they also have affiliate marketing. That's what I also do if you take a look at the description. And then they also do brand deals. So that is where the other companies come to advertise their own products on your own YouTube channel and they'll pay you for that. So that is how they're able to get enough money. But there also are some other fields as well. If you take a look at Unacademy, right? I am an Unacademy educator and I get paid for teaching students. Right, similar is the case with Amanda Tirwal and with Sachin Rana as well. So I think that is how a YouTuber who is in college is able to meet the needs and is able to earn just as much, if not more, than a person who has taken up a placement in some IT company, about like 40 lakhs or something. But you know, it still depends a lot on if you're getting that engagement rate, if you're getting those brand deals, because a lot of YouTubers complain that they're just not getting the brand deals. And or what you can also do is that you can sell your own products, right? So we've seen John Fish, who is in US or Canada, he sells his bullet journal. And we've also seen some other people. We've seen Kalpit Virwal, who sells his courses from a Cat Boost. So that is how they're able to sustain this career. Okay, now, is this something for every single person? I don't believe that, because it's really hard. Okay, if you're not the person who can again start working after 7 o'clock in just a normal day, then it might not be for you. Okay, because it's really hard for you to continue this journey of creating content every single time, and so it can really be hard for you as a person. So I think that is what I would say. It is definitely not for everyone, but for a lot of people who don't like to sit for placements, who don't like working for other people, and who want to get wealthy not by, you know, renting out their time, but by creating businesses and creating value for the people, they can definitely get into YouTube. And that is how today's businesses are run, right? If you take a look at what Ranveer Alabadia has done, he too got to where he is right now only because of YouTube. If YouTube was not present, he would have had a really hard time for growing his career as a content producer. And he also has his own company, Monk Entertainment, right? So yeah, that's what I think. I think it's a very amazing field for anyone to get in. It's very much rewarding if you can get to those numbers. You might have a question like, would I also want to skip placements and just take up YouTube full time, or start my own business and start to promote that business using this platform and using my own audience with that? The answer to that is yes, I want to continue YouTube, but it depends a lot. Okay, there are a lot of variables involved in this equation. If you take a look at how much time I have, like 2 years right now with me, and so if something blows up, if I end up reaching to those big numbers, then definitely, right? I don't want to work for some company, even if that is like Google or Microsoft or something of that sort. I would still be working 9 hours every single day in some office and would be completing tasks that someone else has given me. If you want your freedom, you need to start something of your own, right? If you don't want someone else to govern you and tell you what to do, where to do it, what to wear, then you really should not be searching for placements. Okay, that's just what I feel, and that is also the reason why I'm trying to grow CodeDam, which is a startup that a senior in BitSco has started, Mehul Mohan. I'm trying to grow it, and if that takes up, if that goes viral, then definitely, I mean, even I don't want to work at some software developer job. So yeah, I mean, I've seen Harish as well talk about this topic. He also is running two startups. One is Clinify, which is a community, and number two is Hulock Chatbots. Okay, so he too is trying to do something similar, but let's see what happens. If these businesses take off, then definitely one can be fully dependent on the businesses and not get their job from placements. But it totally depends on if it happens, okay, and if that is a big question. So yeah, I just had this thought. I want to share it with you. Let me know what you think about this in the comment section below. And we are living in some very amazing times. There's a lot of exciting stuff happening in the field of startups. So I'm just really excited about the startup ecosystem that is growing a lot in India as well. But yeah, guys, thank you for watching this video. Let me know your thoughts below. And really amazing to see these people taking up and creating businesses for themselves. Thank you so much, and make sure that you share this video with your friends if they are excited to know about why these people are not searching for placements. Like this video, subscribe to this channel, and I will see you all in the next video. Make sure that you also follow me on Instagram. And yeah, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.